Dragons a 1-point lead with 10.8 seconds to go in the game. And a lot of tense moments here in a full house packed gymnasium here on the corner of Sanborn Road and Route 84. Hester gets the basketball, calmly takes four dribbles, throws it up, in and out. Rebound to University. Hester almost fouled. Barham with the ball. 4.7 seconds left. And timeout, University School. Hester might have got away with it there.
And Emilio was pretty close to fouling on the rebound, too. He kind of reached in. That would have been his fifth. But University did a nice job of getting it out against a little bit of pressure with Lakeside for showing make, forcing the University team to take a little bit of time. 4.7 seconds left. They've got the ball just inside the half court. 4.7 seconds left.
It looks like Hester had a good look at it. Ball went in, and out, came in back out.
Yep. He now fell out. He fell off his free throw a little bit. He didn't quite follow through, snapped that wrist through, and a lot of that is nerves.
If you're Chris Austin now, you go through 5 seconds left in this game.
I think you got to get the ball. He's got to make something happen. He's either going to dribble, penetrate, and kick it to somebody, as he did in the end of regulation, or he's going to try to take it in himself.
Lakeside's got to be careful.
I know. Mutt Narrow said that.
They don't foul the situation. 4.7 seconds left. University School ball tied at 42 in overtime. Heck of a game here tonight at Lakeside Gymnasium. Looks like Jordan Parham. Morrow will take the ball out on the right side of the floor. Morrow to Franks, right side. Franks throws it up at the buzzer. It's no good. We're going to double overtime here at Lakeside Gymnasium. Describe that play.
Well, what they tried to do was they had Morrow take the ball out of bounds.